music producers. Curtis King at CurtisKingTV.com here to talk to you today about your transition from music producer to rapper. You just got to get them bars off, don't you? Well, let's talk about it. Music producers, I don't care how long you've been producing and making beats, no matter how efficient at it you are, no matter how skilled at it that you are, there's a part of you that's been thinking about getting these raps off and getting these bars off. Don't lie, you ain't got a lot of me. Why you stop bullshitting me? There's a part of you that has always wanted to rap. And I can always tell when I get in a studio with a music producer that has aspirations to rap, because when I come in there as a rapper, they start to say like, oh, you should say it like this, or you should do this. They start giving me little tips and tidbits and things that they feel like would enhance the song, and in their mind they're like, I'm just being the producer, don't worry about me. I mean you're a professional at the end of the day. But I can tell, based upon their body language, based upon the things that they suggest, they want to get them bars off, and it may be you too as well. So as you make that transition, the purpose of today's video is hopefully to prepare you and to give you some realistic expectations, especially within that first year that you decide, I'm a producer, but I'm going to be a rapper slash songwriter slash singer, or whatever it is that you want to dibble and dabble in. First and foremost, what I think you should realize as a music producer, you're gonna hate your voice, okay? It happens to everybody. It's happened to every artist. In the beginning, you really hate your voice when it comes to not just general conversation, but you hate your voice when you're recording it, you're hearing it back, you're either too nasally, or you're too deep. And you're like, man, what's going on, man? Mix that a different way. And they mix it different ways, and you figure out it ain't them, it's actually your ass. So this thing happens to every new recording artist who decides to put their voice down to an instrumental. You as a producer, if you can recognize this is going to happen, you will have more patience throughout the process. So have patience with your voice, and also too, have patience with the process and understanding that in the very beginning, the most important thing to most producers when they start to become a rapper or a songwriter is going to be staying on beat. Your whole get down, your whole production career is made off of the foundation of staying within a particular rhythm, catching your particular BPM, catching your particular swing, and really making sure that your emotions are evoked in the way that you express your music. So naturally, when you become a rapper, guess what's gonna happen? You're gonna be pissed off when you start falling off the beat. You're gonna be like, something is evident, shit! You're gonna be cussing out people in the room. You'll be like, just play it again, engineer. Wait a minute, I'm the engineer. Damn it. Okay, I'm gonna play it again. And so you're gonna be frustrated. But the thing about it is, what you're understanding is, in the beginning, you are such a scientist in the very beginning, and you're trying to be so technical about it. Loosen your ass up. Right now, your ass cheeks are so tight trying to rap that you can bust an almond into candy that nobody wants to eat. Loosen the hell up, man. Shake yourself out before you start rapping. It's not so serious as you may think it is. No, this is my life. I got to get these bars off. Can you imagine? Let's just make this a real life scenario. Somebody that comes up to you and they're like, man, I need your advice, man. You're really, really a good person, and I really trust your advice. I'm like, sure, for sure. What's the issue? What's going on? And you say, I'm going through some things and I want to talk to you about them. And I got my job trying to fire me and I don't. That's how a lot of y'all sound the first time you start rapping. And you think that being louder means that you're more passionate, or more aggressive means that you're getting your point across, when all actuality, you're turning everybody off. So the same thing can happen on the inverse, or the flip side of things, in that you may come in and your voice is not accurate because you are in the act of rapping. So many producers come in here and they want to sound like somebody else, and they're trying to basically wear somebody else's shoes to figure out how to walk. Does that make sense? They're basically trying to use someone else's training wheels to figure out how to ride this bike that is rapping. Understandable, we all do it to a certain degree, but at the end of the day, the thing that is going to resonate with your listener, potential listener and audience, is how authentic this story is to you. And you can't fake it, no matter what you do. Certain people are great actors and actresses, but at the end of the day, their longevity is cut off because they are not aligned with their art. If your words are not aligned with your heart, and your words are what people are hearing from you, and you're already out of alignment with what you're saying, no matter what you say or how you say it, people ain't gonna believe you. Because as soon as they get to an interview, they're gonna be like, where all that damn passion at? Where's all that damn anger at? You're sounding like you don't mean what you're rapping about. Why are you lying to us? And it's gonna come out in so many other different ways. And so I think that as you make the transition, make sure that you're writing from a place of honesty. Make sure you're rapping from a place of authenticity. If you've never been through nothing, if you never lived a gang lifestyle or a street lifestyle, don't come in here trying to sound like the trappers. You can't can't out trap the trappers. Let the trappers trap, okay? You need to just get back to your rappity raps and figure out exactly what is your story. And the thing about it is, you're not gonna figure this all out in one song. You're not gonna figure this out all in one album. You're not gonna figure this out probably the first year or so. And that's okay. But the more that you work on this, the more that you dedicate to this process, what you're gonna find is that it'll start to reveal itself to you. So have some patience. Next thing, as you make your transition, don't try to jump all the way in the water, okay? Some people are not meant to jump all the way in the water, because this is just like walking for the first time and me trying to make you walk on water for the first time, okay? First of all, you can't do that. You ain't Jesus. And second of all, you can't walk on water, stupid. Why are you trying to get your ass over there? You can't walk on water. So in the very beginning, I think that as you transition, do it in small doses. You may be working with an artist that is flexible with the idea of you helping them out with their lyrics. So you assist them as a songwriter. In the process, you're going to learn about the craft of songwriting. Second, you may say, you know what, I think I got a hook for this, but instead of you reciting the hook that I wrote, I'm going to recite it. Little small tidbits. It's almost like the way that Andre 3000 from the legendary group Outkast, one of my favorite rappers, if not my favorite rapper, the way that he kind of unveiled that he's a singer was in a very slick way. First, he'd give you a verse, and then like two of the bars, he'd be like, na 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 na, and he'd give you little vocals. You're like, wait a minute, can this man sing? I don't know yet. Then he sings a whole hook. And the whole world loves you when you don't get down. Like, wait a minute, you can sing a whole hook? Who are you? And he's still giving you raps. He's still giving you what you came there for. And then before you know it, he sings an entire verse. I believe it was on one of the greatest hits projects for Outkast. He sings the entire verse. And then it's like, wait a minute. You may have aspirations for singing and you're not that bad, actually. And then all of a sudden you get a, my baby don't mess around and blend them song. And the whole project called The Love Below where he's singing. He gave you this process in a very natural way that all of us grow. Small pieces, small steps at a time. So don't be afraid to make your little small leaps here and there. Before you know it, you're gonna have a whole song that you're rapping because you started off with assisting a songwriter within their lyrics. And after that, guess what? You may even have a compilation of songs you could turn into an EP or an album. My point is this, take your time with it. Last thing, producers, you gotta understand that you have an advantage. We have an advantage, right? I started off as a rapper, so I'm a bit different. But as a producer, you have an advantage, especially if you're rapping over your own beats. You gotta think of it like this. You sit with the process of making your beats from pure silence and you turn it into something. You are so embedded mentally, physically, spiritually, no matter how, whatever kind of situation you got with your music, you are so invested in the music that you are within the swing. You are within the beat. So because you are so physically invested into it, you have an advantage in terms of finding pockets that exist within that instrumental when you decide to rap over it. So take advantage of it. Some of you can't take advantage of it because you don't realize it's an actual advantage. So recognize that you have been already doing this. How many times have you sat there, made a beat, put the hi-hats, and you like kind of like guesstimated who would rap over this as you're making a tight beat and you're like, seven to dig it to bond, heaven to live it to die. You're like, oh yeah, that sound like so-and-so. You already do it. So just take advantage of it. I like to start my song just like you saw in that Simon Savita session that I had with Oh Gosh. I like to start my lyrics with no lyrics at all. Just mumbling, right? Because the most important thing that I'm going to capture, the thing that is going to make this music universal for everybody, is the rhythm, is the key, is the enunciation, or the lack of enunciation, or really the different ways that I kind of use my voice and the utilization of different tones. That is going to be the most important thing when people are listening to it the first time. Now, after, there's some other skills that had to be developed along. But afterwards, of course, there are some skill sets that have to be developed. But for the most part, I'm telling you, you already have an advantage. The rhythm is within you. Thank you for watching today's video. Once again, if you're not subscribed to the channel, please subscribe below and then hit that notification bell. Or there, yes, hit it. Stop playing. Be a part of the notification game. In this life, you will not be full of life until you decide to live life to its fullest. Once again, it's the leading voice of the online rapper and music producer community. Don't at me. Peace.
Look up, Nazi. Say cheese.